Hi, I'm Bob Ward from Microsoft from the SQL engineering team. I'm here to show you today a brief demonstration of the deployment experience of SQL Server on Linux and a brief tour of some of the tools we've built to connect to that SQL Server on Linux. Now in front of you is a popular tool called MOBA Xterm that I'm running on Windows. And I'm using that to connect it into a secured shell to a Linux server running Red Hat Enterprise Linux. On Red Hat, the package manager is called Yum, and so we have an RPM package format that adheres to the Yum package manager. And so the first step I'm going to do is actually run this command, which is in our documentation, on how to download what's called a repository file that gives the Yum package manager the location of where to install SQL Server packages from. Now, we also provide an offline experience, so in our documentation, we have locations for you to download the RPM packages manually and then run them and copy them into a Linux server to do an offline install. Let me run this command first, just to go ahead and download this repo file. And then I'm going to run a program called yum with the command of install. Dash y means bypass any prompts to install the SQL Server package. And what this program is going to do is, using the repo config file, go to the internet. In our known package site, where we have our SQL packages, get the latest SQL 2017 package based on the latest cumulative update and download that. And once that RPM file is actually downloaded, the installation process will proceed. And the installation process is pretty lightweight and fast. So first, we'll extract out the binary files for the SQL Server installation out of this RPM package. We will then go ahead and establish the different directory structures for SQL Server where we're going to put our data files and log files and so forth. We will register a new non-interactive login called MSSQL, and we'll also register with what's called systemd in Linux so that you can control SQL Server as a service. You can stop and start it just like you can kind of do in a Windows type environment. The other thing you'll notice here by just doing this package is that the package is called MSSQL-Server. So when you download this, what you're going to get is the core database engine of SQL Server plus SQL Server Agent. Other packages are provided that you can download separately for tools like SQL Command, for full text search, for SSIS, and for high availability. And that's kind of our mantra for SQL Server Linux, is that we believe in doing a very lightweight install experience in a component way so that different features come in different packages. Now, after you've done the installation experience, you're going to run a bash shell script to complete the install. And this bash shell script is called msql-conf. Think of msql-conf as kind of like SQL Server Configuration Manager on Windows, where you perform all your configuration needs outside of, say, tsql spconfigure or alter server configuration. So I'm going to run this step right here using superuser to complete the installation. Now, we provide all of this through environment variables, so if you want to do this undetended, you can do that as well. I'll go ahead and pick the Enterprise Edition. For those of you who are familiar with SQL Server, you may be familiar with all our different editions. If you've not seen SQL Server before, we offer an evaluation version of SQL, which has all the full functionalities for you to test and see what SQL Server is like in your environment. It has a time limit for you to use. We have a Developer Edition, which is a full free functionality of SQL Server, but it's only used and licensed for development purposes. We have SQL Server Express, which is a production-worthy version of SQL Server, but it's limited to just like a few users in that type environment. And then we have Standard and Enterprise, which are the most common two editions that SQL customers use. Standard for being for those Tier 2 mid-size type workloads, but it has a full functionality of many features of SQL Server. And Enterprise, being the most mission-critical core scalability version of SQL we provide. So I'm going to pick Enterprise Core right here as my edition. And then I'm going to respond to and accept the licensing rights of SQL Server, licensing terms. And then I'm going to put in my system administration password, which I'll need later to connect to SQL Server, to run programs, or to add other logins to SQL. And this program will start up SQL Server, tell it its Enterprise Edition, and establish the SA password. And when this process is over, I'm done. That is the simple installation of SQL Server. I can see the status of SQL Server by using this program systemctl. And I can see that SQL Server is up and running. And I can see the end of the error log for SQL. In fact, if you wanted to actually dump out the entire error log, we, by default, put the SQL Server log and data files under this directory structure, var opt msql. And so I can dump out, and people that are familiar with SQL are used to seeing the SQL error log. As I mentioned before, the command line tools like SQL Command come in a separate package. And in fact, SQL Command is natively compiled and built for Linux, macOS, and Windows. And what I've got on this machine here is a script to restore the Wide World Importers database that I've backed up from Windows using SQL Command. I've got a script here called restore WIDSH. That's going to use SQL Command to actually do the restore T-SQL script for this database. But first I want to copy that database into the directories where SQL will have permissions to actually use it, and then I'll run my restore. Put in my SA password, and I'm off and running. Now this is actually pretty amazing to see. It's simple to do, but it shows the compatibility between SQL Server on Windows and SQL Server on Linux. The core database engine, the code itself that runs on SQL Server on Linux, is the same as it runs on Windows, which is why database backups are completely compatible between these platforms. I could back up a SQL Server database on Linux and restore it on Windows. Same thing goes with Docker containers. And so, in fact, some of our customers who've made this move of using SQL or Windows to Linux have done for that very, very process. They've just backed up their database on Windows, restored on Linux, and they're actually up and running. And the Wide World Importers is one that's a very popular sample to use because it has all the full functionality of SQL Server. This is a restore that a backup that was done on SQL 16, so there's a few upgrade steps that have to happen to finish the restoration. And now it's up and running and finished. Let me show you another tool that we've built, a new tool, a cross-platform open source tool called MSSQL-CLI. MSSQL-CLI. I will connect this SA, put in my password, and it kind of has a look and feel of SQL Command, but there's some key differences here. Now, this is a program that is cross-platform, so the look and feel and the program works on Windows, Linux, and macOS. It's all based on Python, and one of the incredible functionalities that it has is IntelliSense. So for example, if I want to start using a database, I'll put in the Wide World Importers and it automatically gives me a choice. And then I can start running queries. So if I'm not sure which tables I have, I can start going here. And now I'm offered schemas and I can put a dot. Now I'm offered possible tables that I want to query from, such as application.countries. Now, one of the things about MSSQL CLI I love, and one of the sometimes things I get frustrated from when running SQL Command is the results wrapping across the screen where I can't line up my columns and my rows. And MSSQL CLI by default can show you things in kind of a more record type format. And in this particular case, I'm running against the countries table, and so SQL Server can come back and show me these results in this record style. You see here, record one and record two. Normally you'd see this run horizontal across the screen. You see here in a more record format. As I scroll around, I'll see each row in this vertical format. You can actually change it to go back to more the SQL Command style, or you can run in this vertical pane. One of the cool features I love about this tool. Again, that's MSSQL CLI, cross-platform and open source, so you can go and contribute from the community perspective. Now we've also built graphical tools. And one of the new ones we now provide, which is also cross-platform and open source, is called SQL Operations Studio. And the user experience is the same on macOS, Windows, and Linux, built on the popular Visual Studio Code Foundation. Now in front of me, I've connected already to my SQL Server on Linux that I just installed. And I get a familiar Object Explorer type tree like I might see in SQL Server Management Studio. And if I right-click on my server, I can say Manage, and I'm provided with a dashboard of information about my SQL Server on Linux. And a new functionality that we've established that's also now community-driven is called extensions. So I can do SQL Server agent jobs, I can look at reports about my overall SQL Server usage or performance, and we also have, based on the popular SP Who is Active community stored procedure from MVP Atom Mechanic, the ability to put that inside the tool as well. And I think you're going to see in the future the ability for the community to continue to add new extensions into SQL Operations Studio. I can do just basic queries like I could in any other tool. So I can go here and I can go into my database. Now you'll see here that, as you saw with MSSQL CLI, we have built-in IntelliSense to tell us what kind of databases you can go choose from. So I'll run this query here to go use into Wide World Importers. And then I'll go in and start running queries. And I'll pick my schema and my table. Case countries, the same thing I ran before. I'll run it, and I have a set of results. And just like you might see in a tool like Mansion Studio, I can take any query, hit explain, and I can see a graphical query plan or top operators that I might from a given query. So some of the same functionality you're used to in Management Studio is provided in SQL Operations Studio, but again, it's cross-platform. So if you're a Mac user and you can't use Management Studio because it's a Windows tool, you now have this capability for a graphical tool to interact, run queries, and develop against SQL Server. But many of our users here that use SQL for years like Management Studio. And Management Studio, because the core database engine of SQL and Linux is the same as Windows, just connects and looks just like it does against SQL on Windows. So I'll connect here using my SA password. And now I've got a tree view of SQL Server on Linux connected. It looks just like I might to a normal SQL Server. If you've not seen one of the cool new tools we've added to Management Studio, which is now a separate download that you do from the SQL Server installation, is X-Event Profiler. So just like you might be used to in SQL Server Profiler, you can use Extended Events, and I can click here and launch a session to see standard T-SQL run against my server. And I'll go over here to Operations Studio and maybe run a few queries or run manage that actually allows me to run queries in the background, and I can trace what that tool is running. So if you look over here, let me run another couple of these right here, and perhaps just refresh this list here, and I go back to Ops Studio, and now I'm tracing all the queries and logins against my SQL Server. Now, for those of you who can't use Management Studio to do this, Extended Events is a built-in functionality in the SQL Server engine, and there's T-SQL capabilities to define events and even review event data based on system procedures. That's just a brief tour of some of the tools we provide against SQL Server on Linux. Again, the deployment experience is very fast. Configuration separate from a deployment with a bash shell script called msqlconf, which drives Python scripts to help do its processing. But everything's compatible. So backups are compatible between SQL on Windows and Linux. We have a rich set of tools, Management Studio, which you're familiar with. We have a new set of tools that are cross-platform and open source, MS SQL CLI and Operations Studio, and then the popular SQL command, which we've natively compiled across all our different platforms. I hope you found this demonstration helpful to kind of see how easy it is to deploy, get up and running SQL Server on Linux, and then use the rich set of tools we've provided now to both manage, connect, and run queries against SQL on Linux. I hope this demo gives you a feel for how simple it is to install SQL Server on Linux and the rich set of tools we've provided that are both cross-platform and open source. If you'd like to get started very quickly and run SQL Server on Linux, go to ak.ms/get-sql-on-linux and see how simple it is to get started with deploying SQL on Linux and running the rich set of tools that we have provided for you. Thanks for your time today.